Good Saturday evening, everybody. Just past the top of the hour, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick weather update for you. Not a lot to talk about. No severe weather going on. The heat has kind of been turned off a little bit, so we're not quite in the broiling category that we were just a little while ago. And looking again at some quiet conditions into the next couple of days as things really begin to look a little bit nicer for us. And when we say really nice, we're talking about the possibility of maybe some lower to mid 80s for high temperatures, depending on how the forecast goes as we head into August, ironically. We'll talk more about what that might look like coming up here in just a little while, so definitely want to stick around for more on your forecast with us here at News Channel 3. Got any questions about the forecast? Again, please let us know in the comments section. We'd love to know, again, where you are and what the weather's like, so drop your location, city, state, and whatever's going on with your weather right now into the comments section. Temperature, wind speed, cloud cover, general description is fine. Let's just get some amateur meteorology going on here for tonight. And also, again, make certain if you got any weather pictures, we'd love to see more. Sunset occurring right now, and if you have the chance to get outside and take a look and see what it looks like out there, please tweet that information to me at aonek_WREG3. And also, again, you can email it to me again at austen.onek@wreg.com. Also, if you can't stick around for the entire netcast, that's okay. Forecast in the red bar at the bottom of your screen, or you can pick up all that weather information again at wreg.com/weather, and great to have you along for the ride for tonight. Again, pretty quiet for right now, a lot different than what we saw just about 24 hours ago with that potential of severe weather across the Mid-South. For tonight, temperatures again improving by just a little bit. We may see some numbers close to the mid-70s for the metro area, but parts of northwest Tennessee might see the potential of maybe some mid to upper 60s. Now, that doesn't sound like much, but considering that we haven't seen those numbers in parts of the Mid-South for weeks on end, it's going to be feeling a lot different out there than what it has for a while. So some relief from the heat for a little bit anyway, but as we go into August, we may see some of that sticking around for a while. Rest of the evening, again, temperatures through about midnight will be back in the lower 80s, lower to mid-70s as we head into the evening hours, overnight into early tomorrow morning. For the metro, it looks like lower to mid-70s and mostly sunny skies starting off. Sunrise just after 6 o'clock. We're losing daylight now as we head into the darker portions of the year, getting shorter and shorter as we head toward the winter solstice. But we do have a ways to go before we actually hit there. So again, going to take a little while for that. Almanac page for today, almost about as typically July as you could possibly get across much of the Mid-South area. We hit a high temperature today of 91, average is about 92. Low temperature this morning of 76, and 74 degrees is our average for this time of the year. So again, not doing too bad out there. At least we weren't broiling with more heat advisories and excessive heat warnings and all that fun stuff out there. We still have a pretty good supply of moisture for the year. We're over at about 7¾ inches at least for the year, so doing very good on moisture. We'll take a look at burn bans and wildfire information coming up in our 8:30 segment on my personal Facebook page, so stick around again for more on that. Ole Miss catching a little bit of some sunset in between the cloud cover out there for this evening, but again, more clouds drifting on through portions of northern Mississippi for tonight. A lot less clouds in northwest Mississippi from Olive Branch. Squawk 1111's webcam on the Weather Underground system showing mainly clear skies looking back toward the northwest. Beautiful sunset on the Mississippi River for tonight, looking across Mud Island at the bottom portion of your screen, eastern Arkansas, and the buildings of West Memphis out there on the horizon. So a gorgeous evening. Again, should be some pretty clear skies out there for viewing, again, some astronomical events. We'll be seeing Venus. Again, should be able to see Mercury, hopefully, as the sun goes down. Very close to the sun, but hopefully might be able to see that. Mars, Jupiter, and the moon will be very spectacular tonight with some very clear skies across much of the area. 240 and Poplar, it looks like a still picture, but there is motion going on here, and you can also see trucks and cars going across the area around Park Avenue and all the way back toward the Quince Avenue overpass. The MemFix 4 project is in full swing. 240 and Poplar, if you haven't heard by now, is shut down east and west, and the interstate is shut down from the area around the flyover all the way back to Mount Moriah. So if you're planning on traveling anywhere through this location through the weekend until Monday morning at 6 a.m., you're going to need an alternate route, because this right now is totally under construction. You can see a lot of heavy work going on down toward here, and also a lot of stuff lined up right on Poplar Avenue at this time to help the speed the process along. That's going to be going on overnight. We'll bring you updates on News Channel 3 as we have them throughout the course of the rest of the weekend. Now, that project right there is weather dependent. That means if there was thunderstorms or rain, they would have to bring everything to a halt, or at least most of it anyway. Nothing going on across the Mid-South, so things are looking, again, very quiet into and around the area for right now. Rob Smith, perfect for Blues on the Bluff at the Metal Museum tonight. Yes, we were hoping to get over there tonight and take a look around, if at all possible. And good luck to, again, WEVL for putting on the show for tonight. And thanks a lot for reminding me of that. Down at the Metal Museum tonight, if you'd like to go down and hear some great music and get a great sunset. Paulette Morrow, 84 degrees and cool. Thank you very much. Trish Johnson, 86 in Saltillo. Thank you very much for that weather report from there. Wind was nice today. Michael and Tabitha Neal, thank you very much for that one. New Bern, Tennessee, 84 and cool. Paulette Morrow, thank you very much. Hot in Sardis, Mississippi, Sam Dunnigan, thank you very much for that one. Columbus, Ohio, or Arnisha Ruffin, 71 degrees. Say hello to our former anchor, Elise Preston, who is up that direction these days. Hope she's doing well since leaving News Channel 3 Daybreak. 85 in Dyersburg, Valicia Nance. Hope I'm saying that correctly. Thank you very much for that one. And everybody else for checking in for tonight. Appreciate everybody sticking around for this evening. WeatherNet 3, temperatures back in the mid to upper 80s. Add that humidity out there. And yes, there is still plenty of that. Mid-90s is what it feels like, even as the sun heads down below the horizon for tonight. Running the numbers into this evening, the main weather feature at this time are the moving lines on screen showing the winds coming in from out of the northwest going down to the southeast. What does that prove? That is air coming in from over portions of the Great Plains states. And as that works its way into and around the Mid-South area, that's air from off the continent rather than coming up from the Gulf of Mexico. So this stuff is actually very dry air by comparison. There is still enough in and around the Mid-South area to, again, give us a few clouds from time to time. And the computer is getting, for some reason, very overeager to put some rainfall into the forecast. So maybe some more clouds around Dyersburg back toward Nashville. But this does not look like anything involving rainfall at this time. Overnight into tomorrow morning, again, we should be seeing temperatures pretty mild back in the 60s and 70s tomorrow morning, lower to mid 80s by lunchtime. And tomorrow, again, the green color here, computers just getting a little bit too overeager for rainfall. I think it's going to be plenty of sunshine, a few clouds out there, and temperatures tomorrow in the high 80s to the lower 90s. Now, that really sounds good. Stick around because the 7 to 10 day forecast may have some more interesting information coming our way as we go into the course of the next several days. So stick around for more there. Trey Harris, 82 degrees in Dyer. Thank you very much for that weather report. Fairfax, Virginia, Alex T. Freeman, wet in around the area, or Fairfax, Virginia in Washington. I think it's Washington, D.C., I would guess, in that area. Thank you very much for checking in from that location. Appreciate that. Michael and Tabitha Neal, 82 in Savannah. Thank you very much for that one. DeSoto County, hot. Stacy Matlock, thank you very much for that one, and everybody else for checking in from around the Mid-South for tonight. Through tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow evening, looks like temperatures again back in the 70s and 60s as we go toward Monday morning. Again, I don't see any rainfall nearby. The computer is just really anxious to get that rainfall back in the forecast because right now we've got goose eggs coming up for tomorrow. Temperatures near normal again back in the lower 90s. Just enough humidity to get it really humid and get those heat index numbers going on. But over the course of the next several days, doesn't look like anything in the way of huge amounts of heat. Matter of fact, relatively comfortable for Monday. Temperatures back in the high 80s there. And on Tuesday, again, back into the 90s. So that's pretty close to normal for this time of the year here in this area of the country. Lower to mid-90s, a little warmer toward the end of the week, not bad. And the chances of showers and thunderstorms start to come back into the picture as we get toward week's end. Maybe a problem for next Saturday, but just by a little bit. Here's where it gets interesting. Storms over the Pacific and the wobbling motion of the jet stream, that river of air that goes all the way around the planet and divides the cold air at the poles from the warm air down to the equator. There's a couple of them that go around the world and cause the temperatures to shift. Well, if one storm happens and sends a lot of warm air upwards into the Pacific, up to, say, northeast Russia, Alaska, Canada, in that area, that can dislodge a lot of cold air off the poles and northern Canada and send it down our direction. Right now, it looks like we might have the potential, maybe, again, this is still several days out, but right now, through about the late part of July, early part of August, we could possibly be looking at some much more palatable numbers, as in maybe lower 80s for highs as we go into the early part of August. That would be absolutely wonderful. Whether or not it stays that way at this point in time, but it's going to be a little bit iffy to tell. Again, the closer you get to an event in the forecast, the more knowledgeable, the more we can say that the numbers are pretty well set in concrete. The farther out you go, the more things can change. So this is nice, and it's possible, yes, and fairly likely right now. The closer we get to this, I'm really hesitating to think this is going to stick around, but it's nice to at least contemplate anyway. We'll see how well that numbers continue to come along as we go throughout the next several days. But this, if this holds true, looks to be pretty nice across the area into and around portions of the Mid-South for much of the area for, again, the next few days. Hopefully it stays that way. Kevin Dunn, what are the chances we don't hit 100 degrees again this year? About the same as all the other years. Unfortunately, it's kind of hard to say right now. All it takes is just one good surge of warm air coming up our direction to get us into the triple digits. But so far, that doesn't look like it's going to be happening. The hottest we've been this year, in Memphis at least, I believe, is about 97 or 98. So I don't think we've even hit 100 degrees right now. We still have about two more months of summer to go before we hit autumn. So that's going to be a possibility over the next couple of days out there. Tropical air getting pushed away from the Mid-South by that latest cold front all around this latest storm system heading through the Ohio Valley. And that's where some of that rain is coming from. Our viewer just a minute ago in and around Fairfax, Virginia, in that area. Alex T. Freeman getting some rain from this particular system. But this time of the year, the Caribbean, the Western Atlantic, and the Gulf are very good hotspots for development of tropical storms. Now, that does not appear to be the case right now. We also have a pretty decent amount of dust being circulated across the Atlantic from the Sahara and right into the Caribbean again. And that can, again, do a very good job of kind of shading the waters, keeping things a little cooler, just enough to prevent those storms from happening. Not totally prevent, they can still happen, but they're less likely to happen when all that dust makes its way on through and some cooler air comes down from the north up around Iceland and Greenland. So far, looking very good for not seeing any tropical storm development in the course of the next 2 to 5 days. This via the National Hurricane Center, so some definite good news on that front. So if you're planning on heading to the East Coast, the Gulf Coast, the Caribbean, Florida, anytime in the near future, it looks like things are very quiet. But once again, at this time of the year, we haven't even hit the halfway point for hurricane season. That comes in about mid-September or so, and it's not happened just yet. So again, we still have a long way to go before hurricane season is over with. And remember, it only takes one storm to cause a lot of problems into and around the area from what we can see out there. Catch up with my forecast throughout the rest of the weekend on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3 on the East Arkansas Broadcast Network stations. Be glad to keep you updated on that one for right through the weekend. 72 in Michigan, Williams Skage. I hope I'm saying that correctly. Thank you very much for tuning in. Coming up, that should be 8:35 p.m. Sorry about the time clock having some difficulties there. We'll take a look at burn bans, how the fires are going out west. We'll also take a look at weather, where the troops are. That'll be coming up here in about 15 minutes on my Facebook page, Periscope, and Twitter. So stay tuned for more on that. Anything on here you'd like to see, please give us a buzz. Again, email me at austen.onek@wreg.com. And then also, again, tons of information on weather back here at wreg.com/weather, including our 7 to 10 day forecast, weather bug information about how you can sign up for Tim and Jim's weather call, and of course, our complete forecast for the rest of the weekend into and around the area from what we can see for tonight. And again, some nicer temperatures, not exactly an Arctic blast, but at least we are getting some relief from the heat out there, turning it down from broil to kind of a nice simmer out there. Got weather pictures? Please send them along. We'd love to show them on our newscast, but we can't show them if you don't send them. So again, tweet them to me or email. We'd love to have you along again for that as we show again some of your photographic skills out there. We'll have an update coming up tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, so stay tuned for more there. And a lot more information coming coming up at about 8:35 p.m. on my Facebook page, so stay tuned for more on that. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for the early edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. More to come tonight on News Channel 3, and again, join me tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak Sunday for all the latest news, weather, and sports.